And if you're new to my channel, I make a lot of videos on recipes, DIYs, healthy lifestyles, parenting and much more. I would love to have you as my subscriber and hit the bell icon so that you never miss a thing. And today's video is how I potty trained Heet when he was just 2 years and 4 months old. While the memory is still fresh, I thought about sharing my experience with you. So I'll be telling you first when I decided to finally train him. Secondly, when did I give him training to pee inside home as well as outside. Third, when I gave him potty training. And fourth, how did I train him to sleep all night without bedwetting. So the first point is when I finally decided to potty train him. Well, like every other mom, even I was overwhelmed by listening to others saying that, oh, I trained my son when he was just 6 months old. I trained my son when he was just 1 year old. Don't take me wrong, I'm not saying that other moms are not correct. They are perfect and every parenting is different. Every moms are different. But what was happening with me is that I was forcing myself to train Heet when he was quite young. First time when I started training him was when he was just 8 months old and he had just learned how to stand. And what I was doing was that every now and then I was taking him to washroom and I was asking him to pee. But it was in vain because he was so young and he wasn't understanding anything. So he used to stand for half an hour in washroom but he wasn't peeing because he was getting frightened by the atmosphere which I created. So I tried this thing for almost a month but there was no development. So finally I decided to stop. Again, it so happened that he turned 1 and everyone around me were like, you should start training him. And that's how again I decided to find, let me think about training him. And again I tried for 1 month but it was of no use. So then actually it so happened that I was pregnant with Dia and Heet was now starting to understand that okay, he has actually done potty in his diaper or he is doing pee in his diaper. So he was understanding these things. All this while I was also telling him that see, you have done susu in your diaper, see you have done chichi in your diaper. And I was very much focusing on this word susu, chichi. Susu means pee and chichi means potty. I was really focusing on these words so that he understands these words and he takes it as the words for his actions. So one more thing I forgot to tell you is that he was now able to walk properly. He was now able to pull his pants down properly. He was able to sit on the potty pot properly. So all these things became very good for me and this was the right time I thought that I have to now give him potty training. So the second point is how I started his pee training inside home as well as outside. Well, to start I would say that firstly I made him wear pants all the time in house. And I was just making him wear underpants so that whenever he pees and he wets his pants, he understands that he has that wetness feeling. And that's when I made him understand what is dryness. Because in diapers, what happens that I was keeping him 24 hours in diapers. So he had just lost that sense that he is wetting or he's dry. So this time I made him wear underpants and whenever he used to pee he had that kind of feeling that he is wet and he was not liking it and I was immediately changing it. See to it that you change it immediately, otherwise they'll get a hang of it. So I was immediately changing it and I was keeping him dry. So whenever he used to pee he had that uncomfortable feeling. Also he was getting aware of his genitals and he was getting aware that okay, this is the place from where he is peeing, because in diapers they are not at all aware of what is happening. So this was a very good thing. Now when that first 2-3 times, it so happens that they will not quickly understand what you want them to do. So I was taking him to washrooms every 10 to 15 minutes, but on the first day it so happened that he wasn't following my instructions and he was wetting his pants again and again. But that day only I made it a point that every half an hour I have to take him to pee. So after half day or so, he was understanding that yes, mama is taking me to washroom, it means I have to pee. And slowly he started understanding. I wouldn't say that in one day he understood the process, but in one day, yes, he understood that I have to pee. Second day onwards, it was happening that I was taking him to the washroom and he was peeing, but it was happening only when I say him. Third day, it so happened that he started saying that yes, he wants to do susu. So that's when I was immediately taking him to the washroom and he used to pee. Obviously, in this 3 days process, it was happening that many a times he feels, even though he knows that he wants to pee, he feels lazy and he doesn't go. Sometimes he's scared to go. So see to it that you're very positive all the time to encourage him. And even if he does pee in anywhere in your room, don't get discouraged or don't scold him at all. That will be the biggest disappointing thing, or you might scare your child. So I wasn't shouting at him at all. Obviously, no parents likes to wash the pee in the middle of the room. Nobody likes it, but you have to be very patient. The potty training is actually all training. It's your training, your patience training. So this was the thing, and in 4 days he learned it. But again, I would say that every child is different, every kids are different, and the procedure is different. So if my child have learned in 3 days, doesn't mean that your child also have to learn in 3 days. You have to be patient enough. Sooner or later they will learn it. Every child learns to do potty on their own. So you have to go with the flow, you have to keep training them. Even after finishing this 3 days, this was his pee training inside home. So even after finishing this 3 days of training, I had to keep a close watch on him. And whenever he used to feel like pee, for next 15 days, I kept really close watch on him and I was constantly telling him that you go into the washroom and do your pee. So that if out of laziness also sometimes he doesn't want to pee, he came into the habit of peeing only in the washroom. Now, the second thing is, how did I train him? So what I did is, to make him feel more independent, I brought a standstill and I made him pee directly into the potty pot, so that he understands that this is the place where he has to pee. Since his height is not that tall, I brought that standstill and he stands up on the standstill and he does pee in it. He really feels so happy doing that. He feels so confident while doing so. So this was the thing. Now it so happened, now he is much older. He is 2 years and 10 months now. So he uses the same standstill to even switch on the lights. I don't have to switch on the lights. He does it everything himself. He does the pee and he washes his hand. Everything he does by himself. Initially, I had to teach him. But yes, this standstill, which gave him a sense of independence, was a very big achievement for me. So this was the thing. And this is how we got the pee training inside home. And when it came to outside, as I said, in 3 days he was kind of trained inside home, but we were putting him in diapers whenever we used to go out for shopping, especially when we used to go Carrefour, that's a big shopping mall, it used to take at least 4-5 hours. So we used to put him in diaper every time we used to go out. In fact, even if I go out to garden, I used to put him in diaper because we were not confident. So where do I start? So that was the time. I know this is the lockdown period, we can't go out, but that time I had a habit of going to garden every single day, and I used to go out for every 2 hours. So when I used to take him to garden, I made it a point that let's take him in pants. So even if he pees, I used to carry one extra pant with me so that I could change it. So initially in garden when I was training him, it took me really long. It took me around 4-5 days to teach him. And even after 4-5 days, I wasn't so confident. So I can say almost around 10 days it took me, because it so happens that it is his happy place and he keeps playing there, and he's so engrossed in playing that he forgets about everything. And as I said, children are a little lazy when it comes to pee. Even though they know that they want to pee, they won't go to the washroom. They would pee there itself because they feel lazy to go there. So it was happening. The same thing was happening in garden as well. Whenever he wanted to pee, he wasn't informing me that he wants to pee, and he used to pee it in garden itself. It happened one day, it happened second day, it happened third day. But then after, I was explaining him every time that if you pee, if you do this dirty, the watchman uncle will shout at you. And those were my tactics. I don't know how correct it was, but I tried something. I told him that if you kind of pee like this, I won't bring you to garden next time. I wasn't shouting, I was just making him understand the fact. And he really loved garden, and that's why whenever I said that if you pee like this in the garden, I won't bring you, all other children will laugh at you. So slowly he started understanding that yes, whenever it comes to pee, he has to go into the toilet and pee. So that's how we came to the habit of peeing outside as well. And once we were confident that yes, whenever he is outside, he is informing us to pee, that's when we also made him diaper free when we started going to the malls. Initially, we were voluntarily taking him to pee every half an hour whenever we were in malls. But then since he got the hang, because he was inside the home always telling us that he wants to pee, in the garden also he was telling us to pee. So when now he started going outside, like we go to malls or we are going any other place, gardens or as well such places, he now started informing that he wants to pee. So this is how he was totally trained to pee inside as well as outside. It took me a lot of time and a lot of patience to go through this procedure. So the third point now is how I potty trained him. So firstly, I focused on pee training him. Once he was completely pee trained, after 15-20 days, I started with potty training. Till then, he was always in his underpants, and whenever he used to do potty, he was doing it in his underpants. And after doing the potty, he was telling me. Though, as I said, I used to keep a very close watch on him, and if I feel that he's about to do potty, I used to take him to the potty pot, let him sit there and do the potty. But it's not always possible since we are busy with so much work. So most of the times it used to happen that he was doing it in his pants. So when did I start it? For the first time, when I made him sit on the potty pot, he was so afraid. Because doing pee in front of potty pot is a different thing, and sitting on the potty pot is really scary for them. So for the first and the second time, I did give him cell phone and I made him watch YouTube videos to make him sit on the potty pot and to make his fear go away. So once he started sitting on the potty pot, then I decided, okay, since he was completely pee trained, I decided that okay, now it's time that I should give him potty training. So now I was making him sit in the potty, as his timings to do potty were really fixed. He was doing potty 3 times a day, and it was once in the morning. The other 2 times was randomly anytime during the day. So I knew that the early in the morning is the time where I can train him. So as soon as he wakes up, I used to make him sit on the potty pot. So initially he was afraid of sitting on it. So he was taking time. One time, two times, I even failed doing so. He was not doing it. And then once I take him out, he used to do it in his underpants. But slowly, as I made him watch YouTube videos, I just calmed him, relaxed him. Then he was cool enough. He got he understood that, okay, this is the place I have to do potty. And one more thing, children loves to imitate us, they love to mimic us. So what I used to do is, since I was all alone in the house, nobody is with me, so I used to go to the washroom with open doors and make him see how I do pee and how I go to the potty. And with this curiosity, he was understanding that yes, this is the way I have to do potty. So that's when he started understanding, and he understood that he has to sit, and he started doing. It took me around three, four days to teach him potty training. And after that, it was a game of closely watching him. Whenever he comes into that squatting position, or whenever he used to make faces that he wants to do potty, I used to quickly take him to the potty pot and make him do potty. One more thing which I made him realize is that you are soiling diapers and you are doing potty in the diapers. It's not good and it's really stinky. And I used to make him, not literally smell it, but I used to make him smell that from far away, and he used to feel that, okay, this is a stinky thing, this is not good, and he has to do potty in the potty pot. So these were the ways I made him teach that he has to do potty there, and he eventually learned it. So in 4-5 days, he completely learned how to do potty. Last point is how I trained him to sleep all night without wetting the bed. But this was really easy. I was actually the lucky one. Heet was very easy going. So at night we decided that after 7 p.m. we won't allow him to drink more water. So whatever water he has to drink, he has to drink before 7, and his bedtime was around 9:30-10. So that was one thing. Second thing was, he has to compulsory, before going to bed, he has to compulsory pee and then only go to the bed. And third thing was that we put plastic sheets below the bed sheet, so if accidents happen, it doesn't affect our mattresses. So that was a few things we took care of and precautions. Now as I said, I was lucky because Heet never troubled me with bedwetting. Once or twice in between, sometimes we just forget, and he might have drank water after 7. So on those nights, he used to tell me that, Mama, I want to pee. Even after, in deep sleep also, he used to wake up and tell me that, Mama, I want to pee. And we used to take him to a washroom. So I was lucky into that. So I think the precautionary measures which we took, that was a help. But it's not the case with everyone. So if you feel that your child is wetting the bed, don't worry. Go with this procedure. Don't make him drink more fluids after 7 p.m. and see to it that they are not having much of screen time also, because that's also affecting the bedwetting routine. So this was the thing which I took care of, and he easily sleeps all night through. Sometimes if he wants to pee, he wakes up and he informs us. So I did not actually train him, he was already trained in that part. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed watching my video, and don't worry, moms, if the same things doesn't happen with your children. As I always said in the video, that every child is different and their procedure is different. So my child, I would say, got potty trained really early. 2 years and 4 months is quite early. So if your child doesn't get potty trained even after 3 years old, don't worry, go with the instincts, see to it that they are able to stand, they are able to pull down their pants, they are able to follow the instructions. Then it would be easier for you and the training time would be much lesser. If you want to train your child quite early, be ready, you can try early as well, but the training period will be much longer. So I hope I would be much helpful to you, and if you're potty training your child, good luck to you, and bye. See you soon.